This is Asiana Flight 214, crash landing at San Francisco last July. Three died, 180 injured. The following month, VOA was the first to report that the crash could be linked to a culture of cockpit hierarchy. That's when one pilot defers to a senior officer, even if the junior pilot fears imminent danger.
We'll begin with Asiana Airlines.
A U.S. National Transportation Safety Board hearing on the crash in December showed that one pilot did not feel he had the authority to abort the low and slow landing. And now Asiana Airlines is changing the way it trains pilots. South Korea's second largest airline will encourage a friendlier culture in the cockpit, instead of one based on airline seniority, military status, or age.
I mean, why would you have two pilots in an airplane if they're not going to talk to each other?
David Kirstein works in aviation regulatory law. He's not surprised by the new training announcement.
There's probably pressure from the U.S. aviation officials or the NTSB or their own government. There may be a fall off in traffic that consumers are worried about. If people aren't flying on you, that's the most motivating factor there is.
Asiana's CEO has acknowledged there's an inclination in South Korea toward a patriarchal culture. He says many pilots work and fly within the strict military order. Kirstein says other airlines should take note of Asiana's improvements and understand the importance of open communication in the cockpit. In Washington, Carolyn Frasutti, VOA News.